Hello there guys, and welcome back to the channel. And as always, thank you for choosing the channel for all your gaming needs. So today, what are we doing? We are back in the lovely farm DLC for House Slipper, and today we are working on a couple of things. In the last episode we built a cabin in the woods style house. It reminded me of, you know, these films where you would look at it and go, yeah, they'd die, sort of films. Do you know the films I'm on about, the sort of horror films where they'd go, someone would die in this house? So that is what it reminded me of. That is in the background there. So today we are working on, there was a couple of comments in the last video about a Florida style beach house, and that's what you can see me putting down currently is the foundations for a Florida style beach house. So yeah, it's going to be very open plan in the front bit with the stairs in the corner, a bit of a cinema room in the back, and yeah, it goes all right. There's a few limitations with what the game can do, my current version of the game can do. I needed additional walls, which I found that I didn't have, which I believe are part of the luxury DLC pack, which is actually a pack I don't own. So we will need to be getting that to complete this build, I would say, and to make it better. As you can see, I've got the stairs in. They do come back out because apparently you can't put foundations down around stairs. I didn't know that at the time. So as you can see, you get so far and then it sticks. A bit stupid if you ask me. You should just be able to just pretend like they're not there, but obviously you can't. Then we currently build out the foundations as we do. I'm trying to grasp it, but again, the brick wall finishes, so you have to then put more foundations in. Like I say, what I feel within the house builder, the House Flipper 2. Let me just start again. What I feel in House Flipper currently with the farm DLC is that it's basically a demo. Excuse me. It's basically a demo for House Flipper 2. They're ironing out the kinks, if you will, in the farm DLC. There has been a couple of updates already for the farm DLC, and I think they're just ironing out the kinks, getting it ironed out, getting all that done, and then we can go, this is what we want for House Flipper 2. So I think, like, the fact that you can't change a roof, you can't build walls outside, I think it's coming. I think for House Flipper 2, it's going to all be ironed out, but I do think that this is more of a demo, if I'm being honest. So yeah, back to the video. We are upstairs currently. We are just putting in the foundations for the upstairs. So this is the main bedroom where we are currently with the bathroom attached. I tried to add a closet to it, just like a walk-in wardrobe. Didn't work, so that will come out. I couldn't get the stairs back in where I wanted the stairs. And see, the stairs don't fit where I wanted them. They'd lead straight to the doorway of the other room. I needed to make it just slightly a bit wider, the house. I just couldn't get the stairs in, as you can see. And that's, you know, not a bad thing, but yeah, I couldn't get them in, so we revert back to removing the closet and getting the stairs in that we actually can get in. That's what we're seeing currently. So with this build, like I say, it's not minimal. It's some parts of it are minimalistic, some parts are not, but yeah, we struggled a little bit to what the limitations of the game can do, and to obviously fill in the space. So some parts of it may look a bit bland, others don't. But yeah, as you'll see, as the video progresses, I am dead pleased with the master bedroom, actually, with the way that comes to finish. The cinema room as well, which is downstairs, stroke lounge, that comes out really well. And both the bathrooms also come out quite well. I'm dead happy with them as well. So yeah, the video, there is parts of it that I'm dead happy with. There's parts of it that I feel that I am learning and can... as I'm learning, can improve on, which is what I'm aiming to do, obviously, on these videos. So yeah, if you are liking these videos, please drop a like on them. It does really help out the channel. And if you'd like to see more House Flipper, obviously drop that subscribe button on the channel to never miss a video that comes up on House Flipper. If you haven't already, the videos and the previous speed builds videos are linked down below. They are a cabin in the woods, a shipping container, and Monica and Rachel's videos. Monica and Rachel's apartment, sorry, they're the three videos that we've got on the channel of the House Flipper Speed Builds. We also have a full season of the Farm DLC, like story mode missions, and also a full season of Anno 1800. So yeah, what we're going to talk about now is just moving forward on the channel, where I think the direction is going for this channel. So House Flipper Speed Builds will continue to be done. The next one I'm working on has started, so stay tuned for that. Obviously, there is going to be, as we discussed in the last video, the plot that we're working on is currently sort of going to house all our builds on, because you only get three plots now. For those of you that are keeping up with the builds, this is our third. So if I was to do this on separate plots, that would be build done. That would be the space done. That would be everything done. So we're not going to do that. We're just going to build on this plot. And then obviously at the end, that gives us another plot to work with. Our farmhouse one, obviously that's done and built, and that's staying on there. But on the next one, what I'm thinking I'm going to do is a small styled build. So like a small house, tiny home, or something like that, and just try and maximize the space that we've got with a front and garden on there as well. So that's what I think is going to be coming on the next video. We are making a bit of a small start tomorrow on that. The foundations have gone in for it, but I might change them tomorrow. Well, time of recording obviously will be tomorrow when this is recorded. Obviously, I recorded this video goes out on the 5th of May. It was recorded obviously earlier in the week. So I'm trying to get ahead of the builds. What I will say actually, just before, obviously, you know, whilst we're putting the windows in here into the house, is that there was a comment on the previous video about the Steam Workshop. Now, I didn't know that House Flipper was supported on the Steam Workshop. Obviously, there's quite a few games that I play are, such as Planet Coaster, Football Manager, etc. Now, I didn't know these were one, and I found, so I did have a look, actually, on the Steam Workshop. And I found these absolute stunning wooden planter walls. Now, there's a cut there, just obviously to refer to the cut. Now, the cut was obviously, the foundations were done, so I've painted the entirety of the outside white and poured a bit of blue in. Now, that's because the video I was going off, as you can see, the bits of blue around it. The video, so the shipping container on the right as well, and the cabin in the woods house just behind it. Again, both of them videos are linked down below. So the video I was going off in here had a white wall with some blue features, and I thought I'd try and copy it. It does get changed as the video goes on. You'll see that come the end, it actually gets changed to wood, which you'll see. So what you can see now is the floor going down in the kitchen area, stroke entrance hall. So that's been done. And then what you'll see now as well is we'll just start to panel it around. We go with a light brick where the kitchen's going to form, as you can see. So I'll get them panels on the wall there. Obviously, this is for where the kitchen's going to go. We'll get them on, as you can see now. So it was just obviously separating it. The rest of the room, I think, if I remember right, goes white, or is it a light biscuit? I think it's white. But there we go, that's that in. So we do put a kitchen in. And then, I don't know if that's now, so we come into the games room now and get the game room done. We do put a kitchen in early on in this episode, and then that gets taken out as well. So, as you see, what I did, I filmed over a couple of days on this build, and I came back into it, and I looked at it, and I went, no, it didn't work, it weren't for me. So, yeah, we cut it out. We got rid of that. It wasn't for me, didn't like it. So these panels that you're going in now, this makes up the cinema room, this room. So the cinema room it consists of, it's quite basic, not basic, obviously it's got a big telly on the wall, couch, nice couch, but it's dead cosy. That's what I wanted to go for, cosy vibe. So you'll see there's a panel in it. Now, what I'm going to do is while we crack on, I'm going to show up for a minute. I'm going to put some songs in again. Now, obviously, my elevator music goes down brilliantly, so it will be some elevator music. And then I will come back and obviously explain to you guys what's been done and my views on it and how the room's going and how things are going. So yeah, sit back, relax, and just enjoy the next few minutes of speed building. And yeah, I will be back shortly.
Look to the sky, hope is all around, and it's about to ignite. It's looking bright, go on, let it out, the spark you're feeling inside. We're gonna dream a little bigger, laugh a little harder, sing a little louder now. We're gonna dance a little bolder, love a little better, take my hand, I'll show you how. The future holds so magical, shining from our dreams. A monkey see.
Monkey see you.
Okay then, guys, so what you've seen there is the cinema room be completed. Nice couch going in with a telly on the wall, a nice little bit of shelves as well, and yeah, so that's been done. Then we went upstairs and obviously finished off the first bedroom. What you'll notice as well, in every build I do, you'll see a lot of plants. I absolutely love plants. I think that they just finish off the rooms completely, so obviously that's why I went back in and put that hanging plant up into the ceiling as well, and I do think it has really just made that room be complete. And now what you'll see is the first draft of the kitchen going in. Like I said earlier, this draft, it changes, and I'll explain why it changes as we're doing it. So on the first time around, we went for the white snowman kitchen with marble top. Now I really like this kitchen. I think it's a very nice kitchen. I think it's quite simplistic, but it's quite also statementy. It's quite effective. I do quite like it. So as you see, we got it wrong. But the problem that I was having on this build, it was simple, really. It was the window. Now the frame of the window, obviously with them being glass walls and not really windows, so they don't obviously open, but the reason that they were causing me a problem was because the frame at the bottom sticks out just that little bit, and it means, as you'll see in a minute, the wall doesn't, like, if you look, we're in the window now. Well, if you see the bottom of the wall, is obviously it's not a flush wall at the bottom, and that meant that so far so good, you know, I'm getting a kitchen in, now became the problem. In real life, obviously not on a video game, if this was the wall, you'd be able to cut around it and it'd still sit flush on the wall. Now obviously I couldn't do that, so I put that in like that. Now that don't look great. Now at first, one, obviously the first run through of the game that I was doing, yeah, it didn't look great, neither did the table. So, but I didn't really notice that. As you see, I've carried on moving, and I've not noticed it, and I've gone, you know what, I don't like it. So we got a chandelier to match and above, which I think goes really well in this room. Aligned it with a table, and that goes up, and then we put one by the front door as well, just as sort of like an entrance sort of thing. And we got a light switch on the wall that just allows us to turn both on and let there be light. But yeah, that's the cinema room. We just nipped back in. But yeah, as you can see, I don't like it. So we came upstairs and I thought, you know what, let's take five. Let's do something else. Let's, you know, go to another part of the house and do something else. So that's where we came upstairs. So we came upstairs and we got these, you know, the darker grey floors in. Nice and light. I do quite like them floors. And then we got some... I realised that I spelled grey wrong for the paint. So there you go, I've skipped it. So I went for a grey beige on the paint. So there was a cut there, obviously, to where I did the painting. And then a patio door goes in there as well. So yeah, we've gone for like a grey beige sort of colour. Steel grey, I think it is, actually. And now we're just going to finish off, get some touches into the bedroom. So like I say, it is a master bedroom, but it also doubles as, like, I've gone for a Florida beach sort of vibe. But I've also gone for sort of like a Disney villa. I know it sounds really daft, but you know, the Disney villas that I've stayed in the past when I was growing up and stuff, they weren't massive. Like, the rooms weren't massive. They were a decent size, but they were practically sized because they knew you weren't going to spend your time there. So I've sort of gone for that vibe as well in the main bedroom, sort of like it is a big room, but it's also not. So yeah, that is what we've done so far. Obviously I skip that and then we move on to the bathroom shortly in this main bedroom. But as I said it before, if you are enjoying this video, please drop a like on it. It does really help out the channel. And if you want to see more House Flipper, because believe me, there is more, then drop that subscribe button on the channel and become part of the game adventures moving forward. As you can see straight away, again, you've noticed the hanging plant that's gone in straight away. And now we come into the bathroom where we make... Now, I'm a big fan of the bathroom. I really enjoyed this bathroom in here. In this one, it's a shower, toilet and sink with a mirror. And obviously the panels on the wall, which are coming in shortly. But I get a nice radiator at the end, but I do quite like that radiator. But the next video, obviously, it coming on the channel is coming on Monday. Obviously, time of this going out, which is Friday, the 5th. The next video is coming out on the 8th, which is a bank holiday here in the UK, as it's the coronation of King Charles on Saturday. So we do get an extra bank holiday for that. So that is when the next video is coming out, is bank holiday Monday. So stay tuned for that. It's another speed building house flipper. Not much to give away from it. I am going to do a smaller home this time. That is the only sort of hint that you are getting. And now the shower's going in. Now, as you'll see straight away, once this shower is fixed, I did it wrong, put the wrong shower in. So that came out. A lot about this build was being changed as we went. Now, I don't really like doing that. I like sticking to a plan. The cabin in the woods, for example, had a plan, and I enjoy sticking to that. So this one, as much as it had a plan at the start, I sort of lost the plan halfway through. And I think by the end, the changes that I've made by the end do it a bit better than what it was. But watching this back now, obviously, whilst doing the audio for it, I do feel I could do it a bit different. And I do feel I could. But once I am, what I'm going to do is, once I've got the luxury DLC, we're probably going to have another go at this. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, we are probably going to have another go at it. Maybe if that comes with the pieces that we require. So yeah, in the bathroom, we've gone for the same tiles that are in the front room, and then Japanese elm on the wall. I do like the Japanese elm panels. I think they're light. They finish off the room quite nice. So yeah, that is what we've gone for. Now, as you see, the bathroom becoming a bit of a nightmare. But yeah, I think this bathroom actually looks really nice. I think it complements. We've gone for a bog standard light, but I think it does complement the master bedroom, and I think it's a good ensuite. It's got a shower in it, the toilet's in there, obviously, and yeah, I think it's a good bathroom to complement the bedroom. And I think it's one of the things that I think went well on this build, definitely, is that the bathroom is in the bedroom's quite good. And I do like the bedroom. I think the bedroom is definitely a bedroom that I could definitely live in. I do really like it. I obviously try being colorblind, right? I've mentioned this in every video so far, and I'm mentioning it again. Being colorblind sucks when you fit something after, because I've got to try and match it. I did it in the end, but as you saw, it took three goes. You've got to try and match it, and that sucks. It's really hard to do. As you see, we just go around with the steel grey paint again just to match it off, and then that's it. Bedroom done. Put the door on. Once we get the lintels in, because we've now got paint steel grey on there again, which I actually remembered to do this time. There's a couple of others in the other videos where I don't remember to do it, which is annoying. We'll get the door in, and then master bedroom's done. So yeah, obviously that view there, what you've just seen there, right, obviously it does show that you've got the relax from the other house behind, and you can see it. Yeah, that annoyed me as well whilst on that video, whilst recording and playing. But what I think as well, you've got to remember, is this is sort of like a community village is what I'm building. All as one. We are going to go around and join all the houses as well, and do all the outsides for them in sort of like another sort of, not series if you will, another series if you will. But yeah, so we are making sure the houses are in before we come do to the bedroom. Now, I did get a comment as well to say that obviously I'd inspired someone else to do it on the last build. So yeah, that was from a subscriber that I got the other day on the cabin in the woods build. from Jacqueline, so I do really appreciate that. She's obviously started with a central pool with an office building, a bit of a and has a cabin up, but she's planning on more cabins, a restaurant, and possibly a rec room. So yeah, best of luck with that build. I look forward to hearing about it, and I hope that it goes really well. Jacqueline is the person also explained to me about the Steam Workshop. So big thank you on that as well, because as you'll see later, I downloaded a planter wall and it is absolutely stunning. So yeah, just to go back to the build, we are putting in the bathroom now. As you can see, we've gone for a light grey with a whitish floor, a standalone bath, sink and the toilet, and then we've gone for a nice light above it. The reason I've not put a shower in this is because I think main bedroom, I don't think a shower is needed, with a shower being in the ensuite. I do feel that the mix up of the bath in the main one and the shower in there. We also put a towel railing with some towels on. I tried to find the one that I actually wanted. They didn't have it, so I went for this one and just popped that on the wall there. And that's bathroom done. We're motoring through these rooms. Not long left on this video. We're about halfway through the video now. So again, yeah, if you are liking it, drop a like on it. If you obviously got any hints, tips about house flipper, I'm always eager to learn. Obviously, as seen on the other videos, I do like to interact. So any comments regarding, obviously, what you'd like to see or what I could do different. Obviously, since starting the series, we've had the comment about the walls, which now I can put walls up faster because obviously I know to scroll to make them bigger, which I didn't at the time. I know about Steam Workshop, which I've been doing. So yeah, I think it's going quite well. So far, I'm trying to learn more. So I think here we go. And we've gone for a bit of a soft biscuit in this room. We get soft biscuit in this room. So this is another bedroom. This is a third bedroom. Again, the two other bedrooms are quite small in comparison to the master. Again, I'm gone for an Airbnb sort of Florida beach vibe. I don't feel that their rooms are always massive, because it's more about, obviously, if you're Airbnb in it, it's more about obviously being in the wherever you're going or whatever you're doing. So yeah, we haven't stuck to a known size. I haven't followed any plans about this. It's sort of, obviously, it was mentioned on the last video comments, so we dived in and thought we'll give it a crack. This room obviously is a very awkward shape. Looking back now whilst doing it, it probably would have suited being an office, maybe. I think I tried to do it as sort of like a third bedroom, but I am thinking, looking back, that maybe an office might have been better in this room. But again, that's the good thing with these sorts of games, is it's everything's different, but it's always a learning curve. And we know in the next build, which is coming on Monday, we know that we can do things different. I know that I can do things different, and that's what I'm liking about doing these series, is it's all about growth. It's all about learning, obviously, myself as to what can go where. As you've seen as well with this little bedroom, we are trying to make it nice. I didn't like the pictures on the wall, I'm not going to lie to you. So we ended up with a clock. If I remember rightly, yeah, a clock right in the middle. And obviously a hanging plant. I think. You watch, I've mugged myself off here now. I don't put a hanging plant in, that's a surprise. We might go back in and do it. I'm sure I'll put a hanging plant in every room, but that's fair enough. So we move on to the landing now. Obviously the main part of the room, upstairs. We're just getting the flooring, nice basic grey carpet up here. And then yeah, so we're nearly done really with the build that's coming. Obviously the decorations to be done, ripping out the kitchen that we've already put in is to be done. So yeah, we're working on it, we're getting there. I think we go for we paint it in here. I think it's a biscuit. Yeah, we go for light biscuit this time. Oh, excuse me, tired today at time of recording the audio. But yeah, if we go for a light biscuit, I think it complements the carpet and makes it a light space out here. I think that's key in corridors and things, is to be light. I think it does need to be light more than anything. I think if it's too dark, obviously it feels concealed and small. So yeah, let me know as well down below, you know, what builds you've been working on playing House Flipper, if you are playing House Flipper. If you aren't playing House Flipper and you're just here to watch, then thank you for all watching. I do really appreciate it. But let me know what other games you're playing at the moment. Let me know if there's any game in particular you're looking forward to. Obviously forward in, well, we're now in May, but the months are flying through this year. But for me, it's all eyes on one thing, unfortunately for me, and that is Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. I absolutely loved Breath of the Wild, so I'm really, really looking forward to Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. Obviously 12th of May, I think that comes out. I'm really looking forward to that. But yeah, that's what I'm looking forward to in May. I am playing Star Wars, the new Star Wars, Jedi Survivor, I think it's called. Yeah, it is. Fallen Order was the first one. Jedi Survivor, which I am enjoying that so far. Obviously, that's away from filming these videos. I am really looking forward to, you know, the end of the year for simulation games and city buildings. Obviously, we've got City Skylines 2, which will be coming to the channel from day one of release, which I'm really, really looking forward to. Absolutely love the first City Skylines, so we'll be doing that. Frostpunk 2, which is scheduled for early 2024. I'm looking forward to that as well. And of course, House Flipper 2, which will be on the channel from day one here on The Game Adventures. So yeah, let me know down below what you are, you know, looking forward to, what you're playing, or what you are currently watching, what you're liking at the moment. Let me know. So yeah, obviously we've come back downstairs now, so upstairs has been finished fully. Obviously the landing, we went for a light biscuit, a couple of pictures on the wall, a seat area, and yeah, the light in the corner, and a few plants, because obviously plants take center stage. Now we're back downstairs, we are painting white walls to match the brick. This is a room that I feel I could do a lot better in this video. You'll see when it's finished. But it is definitely a room I do feel I could do a lot better in. And I think the more I watched it back, I wish that I did things a bit different. But that's why I love this game. You know, it's a learning curve. You can learn everything. You know, I'm not an interior designer. I'm not going to lie to you. That is not my day job. So, you know, I'm not. And being colorblind as well, it's hard. And some days it's harder than others, depending on what you're building. And this build was one of them. But as you can see, out comes all the kitchen. See you later. I didn't like it. We've gone for a change. We change the colour. We change everything about it, really. So, yeah, you'll see that going in now. But that's, again, why I like this thing. Because builds don't take 5 minutes. They're not 20 minutes long. You know, this build took 3.5 hours to 4 hours. You're watching, you know, an hour video. It took 4 to build. So that's one of the things I really, really like about this game. You can change your mind. And it happens. It happens more than you think. That the mind changes. Like, you'll take one look at it and go, oh, I liked that yesterday, but today, no. So we've gone for a darker kitchen, which I think complements the brick a bit more. I still struggled because in this colour, they didn't have a corner unit. Not that I could find, anyway. So I struggled a little bit getting it in. So it was a challenge. The kitchen in this entire room is a challenge. I think if I could do it again, I wouldn't put a glass wall there. I'd put just a normal bog standard window so that the normal kitchen I went for originally would fit. I think I would put that in there. But again, colour match, everything. It was so hard for this kitchen. So it ends up being a sink. But I think the sink's got a cracking view, so it's well worth it. But yeah, it was hard. It was a real challenge to get the sink in and to get the kitchen to match. Obviously, we've had to put a gap just to get the kitchen in. Again, looking at it now, I could have done it different. Still, again, would have been third attempt of a kitchen. I could have done it different. I probably should have done it different. But yeah, it was hard. It was really difficult, this build. The downstairs part, anyway, the upstairs was dead easy. I knew what I wanted, but the downstairs changed that much. Like that now, looking at it, the gap, having to shimmy in the behind the hob and the oven. It wouldn't work in real life. So yeah, and you know, nice picture of someone ate my sandwich. Love that picture. And then yeah, we just finish it off with some decorations. We're pretty much ready to go outside, which again, that changes a lot as well. Going outside, we're pretty much there now to go outside. We've got 20 minutes left of the video, so we are closing in on the finale bit. Yeah, very plain at the moment. This might be one where we might, in a few weeks, come back in and go, you know what, let's rip this one out and let's do all the interior again and amend the interior. I think that might be beneficial from it. But speaking of that, obviously, that again, another reason why I love this game. It can change at any time when your taste changes. So we're just going to go ahead now and get a wall unit in there. Again, I've treated this like an entrance hallway stroke kitchen diner lounge area. The cinema room's more the lounge, but that's what I mean. Look at it. I'm not happy with that. But we learn, we move on. We put some hanging plants in to try and make it not look as plain. Hanging plants, I'm telling you, absolutely love hanging plants. And then these as well that I put in, these plants. These are stunning. And straight away with a few plants, it doesn't look as plain. Now we put some shelves in here as well. Now I know that some people fill the shelves with books and little mementos and everything like that. I'm not going to lie to you. I do these houses as people are going to buy them. That's why I don't obviously go around filling all the shelves and stuff. If you want me to do that and you like that, then obviously let me know in the comments below. And we can factor that into the videos. Now also, I'm also trying to keep these videos to an hour in length. Which I think also is impacting the detail that I can go into. So again, I think as well, starting on Monday, we're going to extend it a little bit. What you're about to see now is phase one of the garden. I'm not going to lie to you, it changes. I get rid of all of this, what we're doing now. All of it goes, because I took a look at it again and I didn't like it. I like this gravel effect, but I also don't. So yeah, so what you're watching now, I think it works in some, but I think as well, another thing that I need to start doing is start cutting the areas back. Obviously, I'm building a street sort of community. It's hard. It's a hard thing to do when you're jumping in to do these things. Obviously, I didn't know what I was, so I thought I'd try it over here. Over here changes as well. It doesn't change from the slabs. The slabs stay. The slabs are still in place now. What changes is the colour blue that goes. And then our wooden planters make their arrival, their debut on the game adventures. And yeah, like I say, they are a stunning thing. I didn't know where they were when I found them. I didn't know where they were in terms of in the folders in the games. In the game, so in the end, I found it right at the end, and I thought, that's got to go in. that's got to go in, and that it did, in it went. So yeah, this, you can see we put a reef on it as well. Again, I don't like this, and this is what I feel will change in House Flipper 2, and I'm going to obviously go into depth about it because I don't like it. It's a bit like the fencing on this game. I do not like them. Look at the state of that roof over there, that overhang. It doesn't even join. And now I try to find pillars. Now, I would assume the house I was looking at to do this build had pillars. Now, I would assume you could do that. Now, it says you can only hang it on a ceiling. Again, that's not a ceiling, is it? It's a roof. So, you can only put them indoors, basically, in your house. Which I think, as well, is a good thing. But again, we go for this planter sort of down the side as well. We come back to the pillars. I have figured it out that I need a wall piece. And the wall piece, I think, is in the Luxury Flipper DLC. I haven't got it, and I've got every other DLC apart from the luxury one, and I haven't got it. These all come out as well. This all comes out in the next, I'd say, 5-10 minutes. So I'm thinking I need the wall piece, and when I've got that wall piece, I might jump back in and finish it off outside. It's not even straight. I hated it. I absolutely hated it, as you can see. But we come back over here, and I'm looking at it, and again, without the pillars coming in, it threw me completely without the pillars. So we put some nice pretty flowers in here. I do like this little planter. I tried to get a light in it. You can't put lights in it, apparently. Even though it's soil, you can't just shove the lights down. So again, Frozen District, if you are watching, come on. Let me be able to put a light in a planter. I mean, look, I put it next to it in the end. But looking at the build, again, I'm looking at it, it's very plain. So we start to whack the patio on, the balcony, if you will. This goes quite smoothly, actually. Usually these sorts of things annoy me. But it goes quite smoothly. I quite enjoyed it. This is a good mechanic in House Flipper. It's a very good mechanic, actually, this. It works quite well. Obviously, I needed to knock it down a little bit, so I did, and then just match it up. But again, it works quite well, this. This is something that they have got right. Big fan of that. And then we just wrap it up with a couple of small ones in there. Move that up, and there's that done. So that's the balcony done. But again, I was looking at it and looking at the blue. And again, I couldn't get these pillars out of my head. I tried every pillar. I even tried to put scaffolding. I looked for outdoor pillars. They didn't exist. So we get a swing in the middle. I really like the swing. I think it complements this little bit. I think it goes well where I put it. As well in this little terraced area from the cinema room that you can see. I sat on it to show you what it looks like. But yeah, the pillars really annoyed me. But again, what you're about to see now, this all comes out as well. It all comes out. And this is the good thing about starting the game and then coming back to it as well. Other things look different. So yeah, this all comes out as well. Which, it is what it is. Obviously, it's a learning curve. I kept this footage in so you could see the change that comes. And not just that, so you could see, obviously, the direction. I don't know what I was doing here. But again, this is because, and it's a learning curve for everyone that plays this game, right? And I'm going to tell you what the learning curve is now. Always make the spaces smaller. So, by doing that, what I did, obviously, come in, I put a fenced off a little bit and just worked on a little bit and sort of had that as the entrance walkway. Round the side, you'll see when that's finished, when we come back in a moment and redo that in a minute. I've made that and treated that as its own little space, and I think that's really helped with this build. So again, you know, my advice if you're doing a bigger build is to section things off, make them smaller, make it that little bit, yeah, smaller really, and more manageable, because it's the same with anything, right? You're starting with a blank canvas. That, I mean, look at it. I didn't like it. It's rubbish. It's not great. But when you're starting with a blank canvas, like House Flipper, especially now that you can build your own or provide extensions to current houses, it's very overwhelming. It's very overwhelming. And I think it's very easy to get lost in what you're doing and what you're trying to do. It's very easy to get down the rabbit hole of you've just got too much to do. And how do you get yourself out of that? Once you're in it, you kind of can't. Like, I couldn't. I just kept going on this minute. I mean, look at it. This was going to be the thumbnail. So you'll see the screenshot. Couple of screenshots, gonna be the thumbnail, and then yeah, we come back in. So a bit of a house tour now, so obviously entrance and kitchen, diner. I think it looks all right actually now we've come back in. I don't like the kitchen, but I think it looks all right in there. We come into the cinema room again. I think this looks really good. This is the lounge, if you will, dead cozy. And then yeah, we're gonna head upstairs now into the first bedroom. Now, it's a small bedroom, but I think it does. Oh, plank cuts through the wall there. It does its job, I think, quite well. Out of there, shut the door, into the bathroom. I love the bathroom. I've loved the last few bathrooms that I've done, I must admit. So out of there and into the second bedroom. Turn the lights on. Again, dead cozy. Mirror on the wall, and then into the master bedroom. So the master bedroom, obviously, you walk in. It's much bigger. Bathroom again, stunning little bathroom build. Then out there, onto the deck for your view. Either way, again, it's just that corner. Needs a pillar. Simple. Or a wall. Or summit. Needs summit. And that's what we're going to try and work on. So we will come back into this and work on that. So yeah, we're closing in the video now. We've got about 8 minutes to go. Yeah, if you've enjoyed it, please drop a like on it. It does really help out the channel. And if you want to see more, obviously, make sure you hit that subscribe button to join the 62 subscribers we've currently got on the channel. Channel's grown quite well. I can't believe it. Really, 3 weeks ago, we had 12. We're now at 62, so thank you to each and every single one of you who has subscribed. And I do hope you start telling more people about it. So here we go, you've seen the cut, right? And you've got the first glimpse there of the absolute beautiful, look at it, wooden planter. Look at it, it's stunning. So yeah, we've now, this is a cut. So what we're doing here, what are we doing here? We are making it different. I came in, I looked at it. I mean, look at that already. Already that looks miles better. And what I realised, well, I mean, look at that compared to what it did look. Looks miles better. So what I've realised as well, what we're going to do here, we go for this. I'm trying to find it. We go for the wooden planter again, but I'm trying to find the wall strip. So I'm trying to find, obviously, what we can do. So we go for a steel grey one, which I think just complements it. It finishes that side off, definitely. That side looks now miles better, that little alcove. But again, I broke that down and it looks miles better. And that's what I think I've learned most from this video and this build, is that it's to break things down works. Obviously, the blue's still there. That blue goes. Don't worry about that. That goes in a minute. And I think breaking it down is starting to, it works. And I think that that's what I've learned the most from this video. And I think moving forward, that is what we're gonna take into every video, is just to break things down And I think that's where I've been going wrong. So hopefully we can look at that. Look at the planter now. Look how much better that looks. Look at it. As you can tell, I really enjoyed it. So yeah, we're closing in. Got about 5 minutes to go now of the video. You'll start to see that the front door changes, fence arrives and things. Again, I'm really, really annoyed with the fact that I can't put a pillar or a wall on. So we start putting some wooden panels and getting rid of the blue. Now, I like the blue. Don't get me wrong, I like the blue. But I think with the panels, it just gives it that more of a finished vibe. I think it just gives it more... I'll come back and have a look and realise that I've missed a bit to make it match down below, so that works. And then I thought, you know what, have I done it wrong? So I've come back round. Now I'm thinking, I don't like this. So yeah, out it comes. I told you, we rip it all up and start it again. So yeah, out it comes. Everything comes out. Everything. Getting some money back at least, but everything comes out. Pour the water out, sell the pond, start again. Here we go. So this is where we get in. We go in, and I think we get a fence. First of all, we get another planter on the wall, because why not? Look at it. Look at it. Whoever made that, by the way, thank you so much, because it is absolutely stunning piece of kit. So whoever made it, or, you know, whoever designed it, top dollar for you. So yeah, we've got about 3 minutes left of this video, so you'll see that we put a bit of a path in now. So the way I've treated this is that it's like you've come off the pathed area outside into your fence little garden. So we've not made it massive, we've not made it too big, but we've cut it down. And I think personally it does look a bit better. Still not 100% perfect, but I think, again, once the wall goes in around the other side, we'll be able to make it that little bit better again. So as you can see, we've done a fence. And again, there's no entrance gate. I try and find a gate. Comes up with chicken closures and stuff, so I try and find this one, but it weren't going to work, so... Instead of putting it down, I didn't. We've just gone back to the fence and we've just left it open for now. Again, obviously, we'll fence it off. But I think by the end of this little segment that you're seeing now, which obviously was recorded after. So after the full video was done and I came back in and I went, I just don't like it. Let's change it. And we've changed it. So again, it's still not perfect and 100%. But that's the thing with this game. I never know what is. But yeah, we are working our way now just through getting some final touches in, and then the video will be done. So yeah, if you have enjoyed it, guys, drop a like on it down below. Drop a comment down below. Let me know your tips. Let me know what you think is best for doing gardens, because gardens are one thing that overawes me. You know, I have got the garden DLC that came out a few months ago. A few years ago now, actually, isn't it? But I've got that. You know, I've done some of the garden jobs on there and I enjoyed it. But again, it is a case of, I ain't no landscape gardener. It's hard. It's hard to do a garden. Let me know your tips on it. Let me know what you think's best for it. But yeah, if you have enjoyed this video, please drop a like on it. It does really help out the channel. And like I said, and I've said, obviously, if you want to see more House Flipper, then obviously drop that subscribe button on there. It does really help out. So, we're coming to a close. We're just going to plant these trees, get a pond in, and then we're as good as done here, guys. So, yeah, thank you for watching. The next one is coming on Monday. The next one will be significantly better than this one, I think, just from what I've learned from doing this one. Now... Obviously, I'm not claiming to be 100% perfect at what I do. I'm not. And I don't actually claim to be either, but I would suggest what I have learned from watching this video back, from doing this video, is definitely take your time a bit more. I think if I took my time a bit more and maps it out a little bit, it'd be a better build finish. I think some parts of this build have done really well. Like I say, I hope I have done the build what they wanted in the comments, so let me know down below if that is. But there we go, that's what we've come in and fixed. It looks miles better than what it did look. I'm happy with it. We got about 20 seconds left, so I'll wrap this up now. Like I say, guys, as always, thank you for watching. It does really, I do really appreciate it. It means the entire world to me. And always, as I always say at the end of every video, have an awesome day.